Good morning. This is Lynda Cromar. I'm coming to you from my home office in Colorado, and I'm trying out my new tripod, and it does work pretty well. No shaky screen today, and you're looking at pretty much the same scene you might have seen a few days ago. And my theme for today, just feeling the gratefulness of all of my blessings. You know, that's one of the key kind of secret ingredients of somebody that is successful. When you're really, really upset and poor and things aren't going well, it's pretty easy to dwell on what isn't good and what isn't going well and what you want to be making better and striving for. And of course, you don't want to stop striving for the success that you want. But on the other hand, you don't want to let yourself get completely wrapped up in those problems to the point where you can't look for and recognize things that are happening that are good in your life. For instance, I'm looking out at a beautiful scene. I mean, yes, there's weeds on the sidewalk. Yes, there's an umbrella that fell over. But if that's the only thing I'm going to dwell on, then I'm missing out on some of the things that make life really, really good. One of them is family. One of them is looking at what you have. I mean, just today, even though I'm making an online income, I also get Social Security because I'm past 65. My husband is 87 years old. So we get Social Security because we are past the age of 65. And I use that to just pay the basic bills so that that's over and done with and taken care of. And knowing that that's done is a great blessing. I mean, I was able to go in, pay them quickly, and even have a balance left over. And that's not including what I earn from my online incomes. And so today I'm sitting here thinking how grateful I am, because I know, I see it all the time, there are lots of people that don't have enough to really live. They don't have a home. Sometimes they do have a home, but they're struggling to pay their bills, and they're struggling to do even the basics. And I know what that feels like. I've been there. I've done that. And welcome. You can see my little dogs in here. They're not my dogs, they're my son's dogs, but they're part of the family. They're in this yard. And what I want to really dwell on is what I'm really grateful for. I'm grateful that I can pay my bills quickly and efficiently with a little bit left over, and that's not all I get. That's just one of the basic perks I get because I'm a citizen of the United States. Because I paid my dues for years and years, and so I get that back. It's kind of like a rebate from all of the taxes I've paid over the years and my husband's paid over the years. But I'm grateful for the most part that I live in this free country, and yes, it's not perfect. Yes, it has problems, but I'm not going to dwell on the problems. I'm going to dwell on the blessings. Because there's one thing I've learned, is the more you can dwell on the blessings instead of the problems, and yes, you don't ignore the problems, you still work on the problems, but you don't make that your total focus. Because if it is your total focus, then that's all you can think of. You can't think beyond that. And one thing I do know is that if you're in a state of fear and unhappiness and fright, then you're going to feel no freedom. And we're going to have a dog fight. Hey, Bowie! Bowie! Well, I'm grateful that our dogs love to take care of our house. That's what it's really about, although they're actually friends with the dog next door. They're not angry. They just love to talk. And that's how they talk. They just carry on like that. But one thing that I do want to also say is that it's cool to have, and pardon that, when you're in a live setting with outdoors, you're going to have noise. That's part of it. That's what you have to expect. But I'm grateful for one other thing that I didn't know until after these dogs came here to live, is that we had a squirrel problem. They would come into our ceiling, into our attic, and they would burrow in there, and they would have their babies inside our house, and we'd have to trap them. And sometimes we could succeed to trap them in time before they had them inside our house, and sometimes we couldn't. And it was a real big problem, and we didn't know how to handle it. And I even called a pest control, and they couldn't really solve it. And they would insist that it was actually rats, not squirrels. But I knew it was squirrels because I could hear them and I could see them. But when the dogs came here to live, the squirrels no longer get inside our attic. There's another blessing. So you can look for problems and dwell on them and be unhappy. Or you can look for blessings and you can find many blessings, because the blessings aren't, ta-da, here we are. They're just things that are around you that happen in very quiet ways generally. And that's what I want to focus on today. What kind of blessings can you focus on in your life? What things are happening in your life that make your life better that you can be grateful for? If you start really counting those blessings, you will be totally amazed, because you have more blessings than you can count. And that's what I want to leave you with today. Make sure and like, comment, and share on this video. And also, if you want to know more about what I do to make money online in a simple way, you need to get in touch with me. Let's talk. Bye for now.